Okay, in this video I'm going to show you how I created this artwork in Coreldraw and then I had it printed onto a transparency. Stay tuned. Okay, I just thought I'd show you guys how I do this board layout stuff in Coreldraw. Okay, first thing you want to do is open a blank page. And then with Control J, you can go in and set the grid to 80 horizontal and 80 vertical per inch. Okay, and then click on Show Grid. Show Grid as dots and Snap to Grid. Okay, and close that box. Okay, a circuit board is basically made up of traces, which is this line here. And donuts, and I've got a couple of different ones here that I use all the time here. Basically these are just little squares, okay, that are grouped together. You'll see at the bottom here it says group of two objects on layer one. So if I ungroup these right now, which is Control U, they will come apart now as two pieces. So I have a black square, I'll move it out, and then I have a dot here, which I'll delete that for a second. Okay, you'll see now it's just a black square. Control Z puts the dot back, which is undo. Okay, now I want to group these back together again, but you can basically make, like this end one here, you can make it exactly the same. Just by making this square longer, so you'd grab one of these boxes on the end here, hold the shift key down, and it will make it exactly the same top and bottom size. So if you wanted a really long one, or if you say wanted a finger, say like this, where there was a hole and then a finger off the edge of the board, then you could do that as well. Now I'll go Control Z and put it back the way it was. Okay, now I'll group this back together again. Now, if I want to make a spot where a resistor will fit, I will just duplicate this. Control D, duplicate this object. So I do that, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 spaces down, which is 0.4 inches. And if you notice up at the top here, I have the nudge set to 0.05 inches. Okay, so that means every time I hit the arrow key up or down, it'll move 50 thou. Okay, now if you want to move 25 thou, you hold the control key down and move with the arrow key, and it moves half that, which is 25 thou. Most pin spacing on a chip is 0.1 inches. Okay, so let's say this is going to be for a resistor, which you can just copy them all the time. Now I'm going to zoom out for a second here. I'm going to pull in my picture of a resistor here for the layout, and I'm going to put it right on top of it. And you'll see that once I zoom back in on this again, there we have it now. We have a silkscreen sort of like parts layout over top of the holes. Okay, so you can, that's a standard resistor size there. Now this here you would use, it's a little larger. And you want to, if you want to set the hole size, again, you just ungroup. Say I wanted a hole that was a certain size. This one is exactly 50 thou according to the size dimensions up here. If I wanted to make it an 80 thou hole, I just put in 80 thou and hit enter, and bingo, it's an 80 thou hole. Okay, then I group them back together again like this, and then bingo, there, every time I move this, it's that pad. If you wanted to make a round pad, you can just duplicate this one, move it down here, ungroup this, get rid of the square. Now you can't see the circle there, but it's still there. Duplicate the circle and make it larger now, and then go over here and fill it in black. Now this is the key to making your circuit boards work properly. If you're going to have them done on a laser, I always recommend a colored laser. So you have to set these colors to 100% black, 100% cyan, 100% magenta, and 100% yellow, I guess it is. Now, that's not going to show the center hole. So you go control, or sorry, shift page down to put that black behind the center you've got. Now there you've got a round padded hole. Now you group those two together. Now anytime you move them or touch them, they will automatically stay together. Okay? So now this one here is one that I use for chips. So if I want to make a chip, a dip board layout, or donut layout, I'll go duplicate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's exactly 0.3 spacing. Okay? Duplicate. 1, 2. Duplicate, duplicate. There's this 8-pin dip chip already. Group that together. Zoom back out here. Get my overlay drawing. And I can just bring it into place here now. And you'll see that that will make a nice little drawing and board layout all in the same shot. So what you do is you make your layout first. Okay, you know what these sizes are going to be for this, so you wait and do your overlay afterwards. But anyways, if you wanted to put traces in here now, like say you wanted two in the middle, you take your standard trace here, duplicate it, go up to the top here, say rotate it 90 degrees, okay, then bring it in and align it into place, okay. Now you want that a certain size, I want it 20 thou wide instead of 70 thou. I go like that and make it 20 thou. I want it 30 thou, I want it 40 thou, whatever size. You go like that, you make it. Okay, you want to space two of them in there. You go like that, duplicate, put another one in there. Okay, you could have, these could be your power rails. Now you want to make these two longer, you just go like so. Bring this baby over here. Now you'll see the hole on that dip layout disappeared. So what I have to do is go back to it and go page up, shift page up, and it will bring the hole back. So you want to make sure all your lines are below the pads. So that's how your board layout will come out. Say you wanted another one over here. Go to pin 4. Just go like that. Put it in place. If you have to, you shrink it a little. And because of the grid snap settings you've got set, it will automatically snap it to the same sort of spots every time. So you can always, now say this one had to go up further and it had to be shorter. So you just bring this in like this, see? Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take you over and show you the one that I've already made here. So I'll go back out, zoom out. See, here's the board layout featured in this thing here, this video. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to just take you for a quick little tour around. And what I've done is put a PIC microchip on the back here, okay? And then I need some place to program it. So here's the spot for the programming. Actually, I'll take you over to the page where the parts are shown. And right here is where I program this chip right here. This is a serial port output from the chip, the brake input, a throttle limiter, crystal. This is the 5 wires that come back in from the Hall effect sensors. This is the throttle input. These are my voltage regulators. A little breadboarding area for testing and making modifications. And this is all the MOSFETs along the top. These big red wires here are jumpers that I put in just to distribute the current a little bit more evenly. And this red, green, blue, yellow, and this little red and a black here are all the wires that are connected to this. These ones along the top, the green, blue, and yellow go to the motor. The hub motor Halls plug in here. And bingo, you put power in over here and the ignition switch, and it's ready to roll with the throttle. Works with the brake. Anyways, this was my first prototype, so